It's okay. This is going to make sense in due time. Howdy, hey there, and hello. I'm Montez McCrary, the practitioner, and I like to geek out about architecture, tech and gadgets, video games, and professional wrestling. This week, the world headquarters of Stalking gets a new HQ. Solar Spheres greater than solar panels? The subliminal release of Shenmue 3 and ECW? Born out of controversy? Really? Anyway, here are the stories of this week. Famed architect Frank Gehry has been commissioned to design the new Facebook West Campus headquarters just outside of San Francisco Bay in California, which is also right across the highway from the current Facebook headquarters, which will be called Facebook East. Now, while Gehry is known for his buildings having his, you know, signature jagged edges and signature curvature designs, kind of like this. See? I told you this will make sense later. But like the vernacular house that he designed in New Orleans for the Make It Right Foundation, which I blogged about some time ago, for the new Facebook headquarters, he's also breaking away from his signature, you know, exterior jagged edges and curvature designs. In fact, the main feature of the new Facebook headquarters is this enormous 10-acre interior room. And it provides a series of workbenches that line up in curving arcs, kind of like swarming fish. And the aim of it is to organize the facility into neighborhoods that elegantly flow in and out of each space and encourage a collaborative work environment. The construction for the new Facebook headquarters is scheduled to take place in spring of 2013. I like that. I apologize. Now into the world of tech. Solar panels are a great way to generate sustainable, renewable electricity, but they're aesthetically very hideous. Until Mr. Andre Brussel, who designed the spherical lens solar energy generator that is much more stylish, much more sleek, and much more efficient, and it totally isn't the Death Star. I don't care how you look at it. The Death Star is metallic and opaque. This is clear. So clearly, this is not the Death Star yet. Just by using a ball lens and proper positioning, this device is roughly 35% more efficient than your standard solar panel. And there's going to be some smaller versions that will be available that can be placed on sloped and vertical surfaces, such as roofs and walls. Plus, the solar generator isn't even the best looking design they have for it now, because right now it's still in the prototype stages. But it's always nice to see those occasions where beautiful art and utilitarian technology can merge together. I can't wait to see more of this. Now in gaming, and you know what? We gamers, we are an intelligent, wily, and resourceful group of people. I mean, we can point out particulars of stories, gameplay, and other aspects of the games that we own and love. And sometimes we can find those links to games from two completely different sides of the tracks. For example, YouTuber DS Symphony composed a video that links the most recent Square Enix release, Sleeping Dogs, to the oft-rumored, oft-canceled, oft-maybe-not-existing-at-all Shenmue 3. So yes, according to this wild connection, Sleeping Dogs is Shenmue 3. Not really, but it's still kind of fun to imagine. After the cult success of the original Shenmue back in 2000 on the ill-fated Sega Dreamcast console, one of my favorite consoles, and the sequel was released on the Dreamcast and on the Xbox, the third chapter of the game has been very elusive and reported to be dead and buried time and time again, so I'm not getting my hopes up anytime soon waiting for the real Shenmue 3. I guess, according to this story, Sleeping Dogs will have to do. But it's a very excellent consolation. And now we take a trip to the squared circle, and let's take that trip back to around 20 years ago on August the 27th of 1994, where the National Wrestling Alliance, the NWA, held a tournament hosted by NWA Eastern Championship Wrestling, ECW, which at that time was the most popular indie territory within the NWA. But after being under the thumb of power plays and unfair backstage politics from the NWA Board of Officials, the ECW began planning a way to secede from the NWA in a very controversial and public manner. After ECW wrestler Shane Douglas won the tournament and the NWA World Heavyweight Championship, he appeared to be very proud. That was until he had the belt in his hand, he threw it on the ground, insulted the National Wrestling Alliance, and declared the ECW Heavyweight title, which was regional at the time, to the ECW World Heavyweight Championship. And the next day, Eastern Championship Wrestling folded, and in its place was Extreme Championship Wrestling. And they officially withdrew from the NWA. This is one of those moments, one of those key moments in professional wrestling history when it was about as real as it gets. There was no storyline, there was no gimmicks. This was the real beginning of a small indie promotion that got pushed around and they fought back. And now you can't go into any wrestling show or any wrestling arena without hearing smatterings of the ECW, ECW chants. Now last week's question was, what book do you like to reread periodically? And some of the responses I got back were, you know, some of the Harry Potter books, some of the Twilight books, the Holy Bible, 1984, Fahrenheit 451, great picks, and Brave New World, also a very good pick. Now this week's question is inspired by an image I pinned on Pinterest this week, and that question is, who is your favorite Disney princess? So my top three are as follows. Number three, Ariel, the Little Mermaid. Number two, the very historically inaccurate Pocahontas. And number one is Princess Jasmine from Aladdin. Why? Because reasons. So who is your favorite Disney princess, or what is your list of favorite Disney princesses? You know, leave your answers and comments down below. Well, thank you for tuning in, everybody, and you know, please like this episode and subscribe to the channel. Follow the blog at thepracticianerd.com. Like The Practitioner on Facebook. Add me to your Google Plus circles, The Practitioner. And you can also find The Practitioner on Twitter, at Practitioner, as well as on Tumblr, Pinterest, Instagram, and Flickr. And if you would like more detailed information about the stories I discussed in this week's video, go into the description for this video and click on the individual links. So now I leave you guys with this quote from Henry Ward Beecher, and that quote is, "The ability to convert ideas into things is the secret to outward success." So everybody, stay tuned in so you'll be able to meet my special guest for next week's show, Mr. Clint Eastwood. Or not. So guys, remember to stay true to yourselves, stay blessed, and stay nerdy. Have a great weekend. See you guys next week.